Yakın sabır. Speak out. Are you doing justice to your father's hard work? Open your mouth. You are ashamed of yourself, you stupid. Manjunath Jain. These are the answers of questions. You are asked to write questions. Where do you come from?
Obla.
Obla. Oblapura. But you are wearing bankies in the earlier classes. Pradeep, yes. Where do you come from? Have some shame, you stupid. If this is your performance in Kannada, have you decided to take a stop here at 10th standard and then move? Shuttle train. Who gave the answer? Notes was not given and I was upset on that day. All that nonsense, you. Hey.
Sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Did anybody ask you to get absent?
Yes, sir.
Yes, of course. Be seated there. Be seated, you don't understand even simple communicative English. Don't give erratic answers. I am least bothered, even if I have only one student, I retain only one student. I don't want hundreds or twenties or parties. I want dedicated students, devoted students, students who are students in the real sense of the word. You understand? Students are of different types, teachers are of different types. There are teachers who spend their time in playing cards, gambling, spending time in bars and restaurants. And there are teachers who think about only teaching all the 24 hours. All types of teachers are there. But I want, or this institution wants, only worthy students. What is worthy?
Valuable.
Yogyarada Vidyarthigalu. Not unworthy. No parent would like to have an unworthy son or daughter. No sister would like to have an unworthy brother. No brother would like to have an unworthy sister. That worth is very, very important. Be worthy students. your time and others' time also. Apply yourselves. Application is very, very important. Not the application which you submit for admission. What is this application?
Dedication.
Application of mind. Shraddha. We have to apply ourselves to our work. We should show that dedication or devotion or interest in the work which you are doing. I understand that you have wasted 10 months of valuable time because of this corona. But you have to show your preparedness to learn, you know. All the lessons which have been prescribed for you are about hard work, devotion, dedication, service attitude, efficiency, all these things. Then what are you learning from your lessons? Don't fall lazy. If you fall lazy, you have no room here. While going, all of you give your parents' phone numbers. We shall call and give the information. If you continue like this, you cannot take the examination. And while giving answers to the teachers' queries, or teachers' advice, suggestions, or questions, think before you open your mouth. What kind of answer should I give to this? You notes kotila, I'm bandila, I'm notes barakodila. That is not my business anyway. Whose business is it? Teacher's business to give you notes even if you don't come here. Nonsense. Where are we? Yes?
23rd
paragraph. Yes. 22nd paragraph is not complete. Yeah. Yes. So, Satish was totally confined to his room and the whole world became silent for him, and the only pastime for his pastime, this comes from two words, pastime, one word is pastime, you have this phrase, time pass. Yes? What are you doing? Reading a story. Why are you reading a story? Just a time pass. Not even to pass time. We say time pass. That is pass time. Any leisure activity to engage yourselves. What was this pass time?
Reading
books. Who had insisted on him to read books?
His father.
His father. Why had he insisted?
To achieve something.
See, you are all wonderful students. You have skills. You have talent. You have brilliance. But if you don't make good use of that brilliance, it is a tragedy for you, your parents, and also the teachers. Don't waste your time. Always concentrate on the subject which is difficult for you. If you do not know writing Kannada, or reading Kannada, or conversing in Kannada, or any skill that is difficult for you, you should concentrate on that only. If you learn once perfectly, it remains for your lifetime. For example, spellings are good handwriting, and somebody has written his name like this. What
Pradeep, and you don't know where to contact. If you put a line here, these are called downward strokes. Right? Take this one. You put a line here and here. This has an upward stash and this has a down. This is the correct way of presenting the letters. If you write all the letters in the same length, look at this, some people write like this. There are rules for this. English handwriting particularly has patterns. It is written in a particular pattern. All the 26 letters are written in a particular style. Say, for example, seven letters take upward slash, seven letters take a downward slash. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Your letters should look like that. Then only it is English. Practice, I give you exercises. Let me complete this one first. Yes. So he confided himself to his room and he confided himself to his one pastime, and that pastime was not an enjoying for him. Any activity must engage you, any activity must give you enjoyment, otherwise it is not a useful activity. Teaching gives me pleasure, that is why I teach. So learning also. But must give pleasure. You should enjoy your learning. So the pastime did not give him any enjoyment. All the books were full of serious ideas. And he did not understand why there was so much of suffering and pain in the world. Then one day an incident occurred. When he was just gloomily sitting on his bed, he saw a wonderful bird outside the window. He watched the beauty of the bird. He watched the activity of alertness or activity. One must be active. Look at the opposite of active?
Lazy.
Huh? Passive. Kriyashila. Nishkriya. The bird was very, very active. And the appearance of the bird or his seeing the bird became a turning point in his life. Apart from its beauty, one quality in the bird attraction in the village. What was that? Yes?
Knowledge.
See? Alertness. Be alert, be active. And the bird was just looking this side and that side. His eyes were jumping from this side. That side. Mosquito comes near you. And even before you lift your hand here, it flies up. You can't even see it. Crows, for example. Yes? And they just very near to you and you just shake your hand like this and just it runs away. That is the alertness of this. And the bird was restlessly moving from one branch to another branch. ready to take a flight. That means ever ready. Look at that battery. This is how they get the entertainment inside. Advertising words. Ever ready to give light. That is the meaning. And this bird was ever ready to fly away. That quality attracted Satish Venkat. It impressed Satish Venkat. That impression was created by the bird. And the impression created by the bird brought a new enthusiasm. What is enthusiasm? Zeal. Z-E-A-L. Spirit. What?
Got energy.
Energy. Chaitanya. Spurti. Utsaha. The alertness of the world or the nature of the world provided or created a new enthusiasm. That became the turning point. He went on observing the world for some time and the world jumped this side and that side. Darted this side and that side. Then it flew away. Satish jumped down from his bed. There was a new enthusiasm. He took his book and pencil and deftly. What is this? Deftly, skillfully, so easy, fluently. He speaks fluently, he writes fluently. Niravigalavaripari. He does not take any strain. He does not take any trouble in writing or speaking. So very fluently, very skillfully, he drew the picture of the world. He drew the picture. And that picture seemed to be very, very beautiful. And he kept that picture against a stack of books. You have a new calendar or a photo, for example, your own photo. Where do you keep that one? On your reading table, towards the books there, you just make it stand against the books, looking at it always. So it gave him a new pleasure. Whatever you do, give a pleasure. Don't do anything because of others' force or compulsion. First of all, you should show that you have the interest. So for Satish, the appearance of the bird, the nature of the bird, the alertness of the bird created a new enthusiasm. A new spirit was born in him. In that new spirit, he drew the picture of the world. And he was very much pleased about his work. The work gave him pleasure. And he kept that picture there. Okay. And he had automatically, or without his knowledge, without his knowledge, Tanage without his own awareness, he had created another pastime. One was reading, the other one was sitting on the bed and watching out of the window, and this one is drawing some pictures. Yes, then he started drawing. See, talent is an instinct. It's called latent talent. See, you listen to me, when you listen to my speaking, you come across so many new words which you have not heard earlier. Understand here? And what do you think about that? I must also learn these new words. I must also speak like this. I must also write like this. It is an exercise. So one more pastime came and he took his book and pencil amateur Sree. All activities begin amateurishly only. What is the study for amateur? Professional. Opposite. Come on. What did those pictures reveal? They revealed all his moods, different moods. Sometimes he was happy, and that happy mood was shown by the picture. Sometimes he was dejected, and another picture showed the dejected mood. Sometimes he was angry, and that anger also was reflected in that picture. There is a phrase, moves of the master. Do you know what this is? Have you heard of Diego Garcia? Diego Maradona recently died.
Football
player. Argentinian football player. And once a sports star published some of his photos and gave the heading Moods of the Master. And an easy score was scored. No challenge. And a difficult goal was scored. He just jumped into the wave and just opened. And you also show moods of the mister, moods of the miss, moods of the mistress, moods of the master in the house. Don't you observe the moods of your parents? You observe the moods of your teachers also. The teacher is in a happy mood, you feel relaxed or no problem. Even if you wag our tails a little this side and that side, today there is no danger. And if the master is in a very angry mood, give signals from front line to back line. Like that. Yes. Something from drawing to soothing. Soothing means console. Samadhan. When you take some tablet for cold or body pain, they have some sedatives. Sedatives, they just make you drowsy. And they give a, oh sir, you are always taking tablets, you know, lots of water. No, not like that. It is an example. And as soon as you take the tablet, you feel relaxed. The tablet gives, or any medicine gives, a soothing effect on your brain, and the brain is soothing your body will be relaxed. You feel very happy. And sometimes humorous, some of the pictures were very humorous, like this. He had drawn all varieties of pictures in a few days. That means that task engaged him, that work engaged him. Any work we do must engage us. D.H. Lawrence is a very great poet. I will be telling all these things to you. He writes a poem called Work. The title of the poem itself is Work. You go to higher classes, you come up with a poem at one stage or the other. He writes in the first stanza, if your work does not engage you as a sport engages its sports person, do not do it. As a game engages the gamester, If your work does not involve you as a game involves a gamester, don't do it. So what should be there in the work?
Involvement.
Enjoyment. Interest. If you do some work without interest, is the work completed? If you draw a picture without interest, can you draw the picture? No. So all varieties of pictures were there in that book. How he became a painter is the question here. Who provided that motivation, who provided that inspiration for him to draw the pictures? When did he draw the picture of the bird after the bird flew away? The bird flew away. It went away. Then he jumped out of the bed and took his book and then pencil. From memory he drew the picture. There are two kinds of drawing. One is memory drawing. The other one is actual drawing. You sit in front of a tree, you sit here, look at the tree and go on writing the picture of the tree. Or you have seen the tree sometime ago. And that picture of the tree is in your mind, memory, and you just retrieve the tree from your memory and write. There is no dog here. Suppose I ask you to write the picture of a dog. Don't you do it? Make an attempt. What is there? Why?
We have seen it.
So there are certain things which you see and retain the picture in your imagination, in your mind. There are two eyes for human beings. What? Physical eye.
Right.
And the mental eye. It is also called mind's eye. All of you close your eyes. Get the picture of your house to your memory. Can you see your house? Can you see the kitchen? Can you see the boxes on the shelves? Can you see the sweets that are kept in the boxes? Yes, all this is possible. That is possible because our mind also has an eye. These eyes will take rest, but this one never sleeps. So we view it to be. Yes. One thing that helped him was his Urdu calligraphy. He used to write Urdu. Urdu is sketches actually. Urdu. Chinese, they are sketches, pictures. And the sketching had come naturally to him because he knew Urdu handwriting very well. And that helped him to use his handwriting. But the father was not amused, the father was not happy with his new hobby. You are collecting stamps, what is the nonsense you are doing? What is the use of those stamps? Stop it there, do something else. The father may tell you, or the mother may tell you. Hobbies were very, very peculiar. And this boy also had found a new hobby, but his father was not happy with him. He just took his notebooks and went, leaving them, went through all the pictures and just dropped them there. Throwing the books on the bed, he declared, "This is my last time." Idle? What is this idle? Lazy. Don't be idle means don't be lazy. It is not idle. It is an idle. Another word. Idle. What is this one?
Statue.
Homophones. You take 1 hour, devote 1 hour for Om of Manas one day, because you must have a knowledge of Om of Manas also. So the father declared that it was a waste of time. Once again he insisted on his earlier advice, but that it would be useful for him only if he read the books and gained knowledge. See, this is the mistake all elders commit, not knowing the real interest of their children. Even if the children is not, even if the child is not interested in becoming a doctor, learn in doctor of a course. Namgada, injection kurtu. This fellow is already argued with the doctor. Child, does any child know the doctor? No. Why? Doctor is a horrible giver. Because he gives an injection. And every child is horrified by the doctors. And once again, they just mention the doctor's name. What do? They cry. Mummy, I want ice cream. Cold season, ice cream? Shall I call the doctor? No, I don't want ice cream. Why? He is scared of that experience. So, elders usually insist on children to go their way one day. Look at that. When I was a child, my teacher used to beat me on the knuckles. Do you know that? They say, that means your teacher also, but he beat you on your knuckles. There is a rule now, children should not be punished. There is no punishment for not learning. For misbehaving there may be punishment, but for not learning, you are not supposed to punish him. It's a criminal offense. The teachers will go to jail. But in those days, very harsh punishment was given to the students. So, Satish's father also always advised him to read books
and
achieve knowledge, gain knowledge. Because they thought that the gaining knowledge by reading books itself is education. Look at that. For other activities, for other talents, there was no encouragement. Come new education policy from next year, all these books become irrelevant. If you are a very good singer, if your voice is very good, you can possess your education only in singing. If you are a painter, you can continue in painting. If you are a runner, you can show your interest only in skills. If you are very good at electrician thing, electrical things, then you can become an electrician. If you are good in speaking or teaching, then you can become a teacher. So like that, a skill-based education is coming on the way. Here in this bookish education, there is no encouragement for skills. Slowly we have introduced all these things. Good handwriting is a skill, good speaking is a skill, spoken English is introduced. All these things are there, but very, very mild, very, very weak. Yes. Okay. You would do better to read and get some knowledge, except for this. So, father always insisted on reading. Do you like parents' advice?
Sometimes.
Yeah. If it is favorable for you, you like. Right? Otherwise, what do you do? Come on. I am trying to get you one word impressed in your mind, registered in your mind. Do you say anything out? and they give you advice, do you respond? In most cases, when they advise you, do you respond? Do you speak out or remain silent? Amen? Most cases, 99% of the cases, you remain silent. Are you happy? Are you happy with your advice? Come on. Not sometimes, very, very rare that one. Once again, 1 in 1,000 only. Yes? You have no knowledge of which is good and which is bad. Otherwise, the question of advising does not come into play. Because you cannot discriminate between good and bad, we are there to tell you which is good and which is bad. That is the elder's responsibility. And listening to the elder's advice is your duty. So on one side it is duty, on the other side it is a responsibility. And most children, when unfavorable advices are given, they sulk, they remain silent, instead they are angry. Look at that. So that feeling is called sulking. Satish did not like his father's advice. He did not like his father throwing his pictures down the table. Though he could not hear, he just read the father's lips and understood what the father was saying. Read books. Read books. He did not like it. He did not like the father's advice. Nor did he stop his drawing. Nor did he stop his drawing, because drawing has become his favorite
pastime.
Use words like that. Now, you can speak better than me, because you belong to another generation. I have seen 46th generation of students, 47th year. So many changes have taken place. And your brains are very, very sharp, because you belong to 2021 generation. 21st century, first quarter, that generation, you must be very sharp. Okay? And then the mother interfered. Umpire. Mother love is with the duty of the umpire. Out or not. And he just suggested to the husband not to insist on knowledge only or books only, but allow him to do his work according to his self. Why do you take away the source of his source of entertainment? Asked the mother one. So she suggested to him not to take away the only source of entertainment for a suggestion. Happy with him. Of realizing his mistake. Oh, that. Oh, that. He realized his mistake. But whenever elders realize their mistakes, they don't openly say it. Do they? No. Because the elderliness comes in the way. Why should I preach to my son? And the son also defiled. Why should I preach to my father? Yes. Once again, he insisted that he never thought that his son could make a livelihood by drawing pictures. Down your hands. Getting headache. Enjoy. Enjoy teaching. Yes. Moreover, the life of artists has been very difficult always. poets. They call themselves artists, they call themselves sons of Saraswati, and they call themselves movers in the world of imagination. Kalpana Prabhanchatari Maharshi Rao, Saraswati Makkalava Rao, Samaja Ovari Ovari Nirthakanta Sahiti Rao Rao. They say all these things. But when do they get money? Yes? Very late in life. How much? Just a pittance. What is pittance? There is a word pittance there.
Low.
Huh? Low. Very, very low. Do you give 100 rupees note to beggars? Huh? How much do you give? Lowest denomination you search in your purse. If the 50 paisa coin is there, it is worth only 50 paisa. If 50 paisa is not there,
1 rupee.
Not 10 rupees. Not even 2 rupees. And that's the wrong. 1 rupee. How many 1 rupees should I get to make money? So, artists always suffer in poverty and they are always got away. Negligible, legal income, according to this part. But today, it's just by writing one book or one story, they become international figures. Chetan Bhagat, for example, Arundhati Rai, for example, and a 13-year-old girl has become an internationally recognized writer, and a 5-year-old boy has written a story which has become state famous. Also are there, okay. But their son was a very bright boy, intelligent boy, was very brilliant. And drawing or painting should not become a profession for a very brilliant boy. Moreover, yes, he has to study if he has to make something out of his life. He has to study or he must study. He need to study. He ought to study if we have to become successful in life. Everybody wants the children to rise to heights in life. So that father also had very high hopes of his son becoming a great scholar or a man of knowledge. Moreover, he was very hopeful about Satish's condition. What was his hope? Yes? That he would get back
his
hearing capability. One day or the other, sooner or later, either by his doctor or by another doctor. So he had not stopped his efforts. When it does, he must be prepared to go back to school, mustn't he? He asked. So when he got back his hearing capacity, what should he do?
He
has to go back to the school. Mustn't he? Look at that. It's a question tag. He must be prepared to go back to the school, mustn't he? Question tag. Mustn't he? Isn't he or she aren't? I'll take up 1 hour for the present time. Very easy. Okay. By that time, he had become 11 years old. And the mother contradicted. The mother contradicted. She had no hope that the son would get back his head. Because it was already 3 years since he lost his hearing capability. And there was no hope for her. Yes, it has been more than 3 years since he became ill. How do you possibly think that he can recover his hearing? Asked the mother. She became desperate, hopeless about the son's condition. But father and mother, who do you think is more hopeful? Usually. Come on. They weigh the positive, they weigh the possibilities. Come on, let us take a chance. And the mother said, be careful. Even before you go out of the fathers don't bother what you do outside. Do they give you advice when you are going outside? Last word is take care. I never gave advice to any of my children. That's a different matter. The varieties of them. There may be some exceptions also. But most mothers have these two hopes. Most fathers have most hopes, not even more hopes than most hopes. They are ready to take chances. So here also, that dichotomy maintained difference is there. So you are not ready to lose his hope. So he told his wife that he was not, they should not lose hope because one day or the other they are going to recover from that one. We must always be optimistic about his chances of recovery. Optimistic. Optimism, optimistic. What is optimistic? It is high time you improve your vocabulary. Having hope, asha or belief, I am an optimist. Never say never die again. That is the name of the movie. Never say never die again. Optimistic. Pessimistic. You have heard these things. Always say I can. Never say I can't. Never say I can is optimism. I can't is a pessimism. Don't be pessimistic in life. Never become hopeless in your life. Yes. So, he chided his wife. What is chided? Not scolding. Scolding is different. Blaming is different. Admonished his wife. Mildly advised her. So, he advised her wife not to lose her hopes. And he was hopeful that one day or the other, Satish would get back to his hearing capability. Right? We should stop it at that. Now you just take writing books. Write this one. Take for example, you are writing like this. There are two lines. Four-line book is too late for a book, right? Write this one. Try to keep the shape of the letters always the same body. Moderately, don't read this line. There is another line, you know. Finished. Write one page like that. Fit at home tightly. Right? In the night when you have no work at all. After completing all your work, you just do this exercise. All of them see. This is the body of the letter. Understand? All this. This body of the letter, all the letters must look at least uniformly. The shape of the body of the letter should be equal. One letter should not be too thick, another one too lean. Like that. And there should be enough space from one letter to another letter. How do we sit? Do we sit beside one another? Do we sit very closely like this? No. So letters also must be given that kind of space there. So leave enough space, but not too much space. Take for example A, B, C, not like this. 1 acre. If you put a line here, all of them must look separate. And then upward slashes. Practice that 7 letters get upward slashes. 7 letters take downward slashes. Right? All these letters, see, what you have to learn in English writing is one line like this. And one zero like this. One half zero. One inverted half zero. One dash like this. When you write these things, see, this A is there, or this A is there, or this A is there. Two lines are there. What is this? This one, to put a like this, or put a zero like this. D for example, you are writing here. E for example, you are writing here. These are called patterns. To develop your handwriting through patterns. Think about these things. And when you take A, for example, this A takes its, this one, downwards only. And whenever you want to join another letter to A, you have to join it from the bottom only. Right. All. Suppose you are writing a O from top. Because if you take from here, it becomes 18. Water. Water in water in near 9. That one. And M, looking that this is a small M and this is a capital M. Never. This is a small M. 1, 2, 3 decks must be there. And this is a N. Always keep these things in your mind. Practice it. In just 1 week, you can change your hand. Thank you very much. On Friday onwards,